Three words that were talked about for this segment: community, development, sustainability. And we decided to focus on community because we feel that, well, it was important to try to establish a common ground or try to see if there was one. Throughout, you know, some thoughts, feelings about what that word means to us, even though it's in English and for most of us it's a foreign language. But it has certain, it brings us back to our own languages and our own cultures and our own places and evokes certain things. And because we thought that, I'm glad that Hossein, your colleague, brought up the issue, that I think it is important to ask whether there is a link at all between community and sustainability. My answer is that there is, that my personal answer. For some of us, it is very important to establish that fact. Comunidad in Oaxaca just briefly means something related, similar to what Claude was talking about earlier. It's a group of people in a particular place, piece of land, territory, that are very much rooted in that place and have an intrinsic responsibility of relation with each other and with that nature around them. It doesn't mean only being together when it's nice or when they're happy or when they share a certain common set of interests, but it's a group of people and a group of families who establish the norms to live together and look after each other and look after their environment and the place where they are. And to a certain degree, they have this sense of autonomy that prevents certain things that are harmful from contaminating their community or having a sense of who they are and who that place is and how to protect it. It's what's allowed for 500 years, 16 different ethnic groups, which represent 80% of the population of Oaxaca, to survive to this day. After the conquest of the Spaniards, after 500 years of colonization from the same Spaniards and their descendants, after a constant attack on their way of life, their way of thinking, their way of doing things, their way of learning, of schools and political parties coming in to try to break up those communities and send them off to the cities or to Mexico City or to the United States to work as migrant workers, this sense of community has allowed them to remain strong and remain as community with this sense of very complex set of relations and responsibilities and duties and obligations to each other, which allow them to be free, which allow them to remain on their land despite everything that has threatened their very existence. And that's just what comunidad connotes in Oaxaca particularly. I'm not even speaking about the Spanish language. In Guatemala, it means something completely different. But in Oaxaca, that's what comunidad means. And we thought that it was important to bring up these three words to get us thinking about how they are related, if they're related at all. And to the words this morning, we were talking about the environment and nature. And is there a relation or not between, does it seem irrelevant to you to talk about community in this context? We hope it doesn't. We feel that there is an intrinsic relation between all of these words. And so Nitin, if you would like to lead us to the
community.
So we have some walnuts, raisins, lemons. And we make these. One with cucumber.
Yes.
One with cucumber.
This one
and this.
With onion and lemon.
There's no onion here. Can you mix apples in that?
Yes. So lemon. This one.
Are these? One.
Is that lemon? Yeah. And all
this will go in this.
Yes. Yes.
Yo,
زیبایی رو داشتن برای اینکه این حسی هستی که در همه انسان‌ها وجود داره و در درون همه هست و باید اینطوری نیستش که اول باید آموزش ببینیم یه کاری بکنیم بعداً زیباش بکنیم. اگر این حس زیبایی رو از اول بشناسیم و شکوفا کنیم خودش به بیرون منتقل میشه.
And another thing that modernity does is that it creates unwanted terminologies and you are stuck in that. You don't go to the real. You know, like words like tradition, modernity, when they say that tradition is uncreative, modernity is creative, there are several such terminologies that are put in. Because when you go to a rural tribal area, and when you ask them whether they are traditional or modern, they don't know what you mean. So I find that these are all intellectual games. People who are actually working and creating are disengaged from any of these kind of things. Because if you see this style that is done by a woman who has never been to any school, is doing so beautiful well, where is the, where do you place it? Is
a tradition, is a modern, you know? یکی از گیرهایی که توی نگاه مدرن هست و تحصیلات آکادمیک که ما گرفتیم بود که همش اسیر کلمات میشیم. واژه های مثل سنتی، مدرن، پیشرفته، غیره، این واژه ها ما رو از اون زیبایی و معنای اصلی دور میکنه، در حالی که برای زن روستایی که این کاشی ها رو درست کرده اصلا شما اگه از یه روستایی بپرسید که شما سنتی هستین یا مدرن، اصلا براش این سوال بی‌معنیه. همونی که هست هست و شما الان نمیتونید بگید سنتی یا مدرن، اصلا شاید سوال خطاست. همه اینا یه بازی ذهنیه که ما بی خود دچار شدیم.
Actually, I mean, quickly run through just few of the very interesting pieces that we have been creating. Actually, see, one of my preoccupation is to be original. And that is what I tried in this groups also, that don't copy from anybody. Because the source is inside us.
یکی از دردهای من اینه که اوریجینال خودم باشم و از درون بجوشه.
So all that you see here is actually very much original in the sense that, of course, I was supporting about 40 families in that community, working together with families, and we market our products, and every time we have to be on the toe. That we have to know that, you know, this doesn't sell, then we have to create new things. And every time interacting with market, and it was not in an NGO kind of a mode, it was purely a kind of a business mode, because I felt that if craft has to survive, it must be supported by people, and not subsidized by other organizations.
کاری که انجام
داد. This is what you know. What I just saw that all the pottery outside, it's a simple potter's work. So it is from exactly that kind of skill that I took them into this kind of a skill. See, one of the things I did was not to introduce technology or anything like that. I wanted to tell the potter that his skill is more than enough. His technology is more than enough. We don't need new technologies. You know, what they have is good enough. It is that they don't understand what is now needed. What is the market that is there. So that is a shift that I made. So it's simple, you know, lampshades that made from the wheel.
In نمونه کارهایی که ساخته شده اونها گفتن من الان نگاه میکردم این گلدونایی که اینجا هست کار سفالگرای ایرانی کار دسته و مشخصه که در این یه مهارتی هست و وقتی من با این جوام کار میکردم و سفالگرا این حس رو بهش نمیدن که شما نیاز به تکنولوژی دارین که این اعتماد به نفس رو از دست ندن این بود که اون مهارتی که دارن کافیه فقط باید بازار رو بهتر بشناسن و بتونن حس زیباییشون رو با بقیه به ارتباط بذارن و این چیزایی که ساختن سعی کردن که متناسب با نیاز بازار